Why don't I like stuff like that? It'd be less lonely, right? Be with all those people. So we came across something kind of neat. I do believe this is called Spray Falls. And the reason why I know that is about a half an hour ago, I stopped on a random beach and there were some through hikers, this couple from Missouri, and they asked me, is Spray Falls down there? And I'm like, I have no idea. but I'm assuming this is what they were talking about. So I gave them a couple of beers and some trail mix and they loved it. So good deed for the day. People through. Just trying to get a little bit of a close up here. I'm watching the depth really close. Man, the water's so green, it's like emerald. Pictured rocks, guys. Well, it always feels good to get back into protected water. Even kind of being blown around all day today, so. But that's just part of the adventure. We're back in Grand Marais, and I hope you guys like seeing pictured rocks. So day two here in Grand Marais, Michigan. Just got some coffee from the little Volkswagen bus that you saw in the last episode. And I think we're going to go out and go fishing. I was talking to a local here that lived next door to the coffee place there, and he kind of gave me an idea where to go out and possibly catch some lake trout. So I think we're going to go try it for a couple hours this morning. But first I wanted to show you... So this is kind of how this stuff works, at least in my world. Maybe, I bet you it does for some of you guys too. I've been wanting to move for a while, but I don't want to do a downward move or a unilateral move. I love Ontonagon, but I'm just kind of ready for a change. And I've always liked this town of Grand Marais, but it's definitely been discovered. And it's hard to find good deals and stuff anymore. Kind of like Ontonagon now. But the guy I was talking to about fishing, he said, hey, go look at that little house around the corner. You know, it's an original fish house. I'm gonna show you guys in a minute. But he gave me the lady's number. She's like 70 years old. I just looked her up. And I don't know. I just called and she wasn't answering, but I'm gonna keep trying. And who knows? Maybe I can buy this place cheap, fix it up, and have a home base in another cool little part of the UP, so. But yeah, enough yapping. Let me show you guys this house real quick.
It reminds me of something out of the shipping news. Like some little outport town in Newfoundland, a fishing house, which is kind of what a lot of the little towns in the UP are like, really, to tell you the truth, especially on the, you know, Lake Superior. And of course it does need, you know, a full refurb, but my style would be just throw a metal roof on it and I don't know. Make do. I don't really need anything fancy. Stick my ice castle in the backyard.
You can see this. I don't know if you can see that, but let me see if I can get it to focus. But,
yeah. Get the number there. Windows are kicked open upstairs. You know, she probably gets asked every summer if from people, but it's always worth a try. Maybe this lot would go with it. Yeah. Okay, guys, let's go fishing. Load up. Go. 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 So when in doubt, guys, when you're when you don't know the waters, you don't know where to fish, you often just come where the other boats are. There's one other boat out here, and it looks like there's a shelf out here where it drops off pretty abruptly, and that's why they're fishing it. So I'm gonna give that a try right now. I'm at 124 feet. I'm gonna try that. Okay guys, I'm trying to ride this ridge. It's pretty abrupt out here. It just goes for about, it looks like 125 feet, just drop off substantially into the 200s. And often lake trout, all fish really, like to hang out on those edges. I guess that's where they like to feed. So I'm trying to ride that right now, and well, we'll see here. Yeah, you can see it's, see if I can get back into the 125s here. And I'm doing everything by myself. Steering, putting poles out, managing the depths, as always. The beagle's no help. Okay guys, I'm gonna try to capture this for you. Hopefully you'll be able to see this. Side, so this color must be good. There we go. You can see here, guys, that the graph is picking up fish. That those little arcs are most likely lake trout hanging on the bottom. Okay, guys, I think we got another one. Let's see if I can capture us. Capture this for you. The first feels pretty big. Number three. I think that's our limit, guys. Okay, guys, so we got three. I'll show you guys in a minute. But I thought I would just turn off the motor and sit out here and talk for a couple minutes. Alright guys, well it looks like Grand Marais has a fish cleaning station. So I'm gonna get some fillets off of these fish and I'll show you how I do it.
While you're cleaning?
Yeah, just for a minute or two.
Yeah, I can do that. I got a buddy that was from Ontonagon.
What's his name?
Well, actually he married a gal that was from up there. Mm-hmm. And they owned a big farm up there. But they've sold most of it now. I think they still got like a 50-acre partial. But
these are huge.
Bloody massacre here.